So let's start. Today we're going to talk about a solution for building openEHR applications that allows to build applications fast. And we call it EHR forms, we'd like to make this demo vice versa. Not to explain you how it works, we will do it after our presentation. And first of all, we'd like to show you, and we will create a form in a minute based on your OPT template that you have sent us. Mm-hmm. And you will see the result. We will do it online. And after that, we will show you how to do any visualization on the clinical data based on openEHR model you may want. And this is the screen just to present that our solution is very flexible. And the next part, we will explain what was going on and how we did it, how it works inside, and so on. So first of all, what do we want for today for your pre-procurement demo? We would like to share our experience how to build full-scale open-air solution that can work in at your region, and we have the same experience for the city of Moscow, and we'd like to share insight into interesting features with your team of building open-air solution. And then the last part, we'd like to answer your questions. I think that you have received our technical details and you have a lot of questions, I guess. Okay. And why are we doing this solution? We're doing this project because we want, first of all, we want to speed up application development for the region. We want to multiple companies and teams to be involved in the healthcare project development. We want to hide the complexity of clinical documents based on openEHR and decrease the development costs. And the next, we want different kind of archetypes like forms, widgets, UI elements to be reusable between applications by multiple teams without reinventing the wheel. And we want to give the clinicians any UI they want. So the results for today, we have launched our solution for the city of Moscow, and there are about 300 forms have been created by many companies, and about 30,000 clinicians are working with forms every day in production. And there are about 15 front-end applications using EHR forms in production also. So today's speakers, my name is Eugene Leonov. I'm the CTO of Solit Clouds company and chief architect of the EHR forms solution. My colleague Rostislav Terekhov, EHR forms, he's a product owner and he drives the team to get the best result.
Hi everyone.
And Alexander Zyborov, he is our lead system analyst, and he will show how to create a form and how to hit the most of the hints you have sent us in the mail. And so, to make the demo vice versa, I'll give the word to my colleague, and he will show how to create the form.
Sorry, we have only one left. So I start with logging in the system. This is a forms list screen, and I will start with creating the form. This will be demo form. Now I will select one of the templates. The template you have sent us, it is good because we had to upload it and not to interfere with our system, we change it name. So I proceed to the form builder itself. Here is the constructor. I will drag the whole composition in the slot. The form structure is generated automatically according the template. I will start with generating parts of the form called widgets in our terminology. Here they are. So most of the form is already created and ready to work with, but some parts need to be tuned. First of all, the field traumatic injury. I will change it for drop down list, and I will connect it to the outer terminology, so to the injury terminology.
We have seen that there is a connectivity lag for about 1 second, so maybe our voice will be a bit faster than the image.
Okay. Yes, I see it on another laptop, and it is not good for
but for us, I think it looks good for us.
So
here you may see the traumatic injury terminology. It is only first like level of SNOMED vocabulary, but I already have a part of the terminology. Now I will change it for a pre-made component. It has a bit different structure. It's a tree structure with the possibility of text search. So I will search for the blast disorder as was suggested in the example and select it. I may enter any kind of info in the text fields. Now the body side, it requires the outer terminology too. It can be tuned in several ways. I may set the terminology in the form by adding any kind of values to set. So I have arm, but it's not very representative and it's not the SNOMED terminology. The other pre-made component is a body image. It can be selected. So now I select an arm. It will still be sent to the composition in the SNOMED terminology. It can be checked in the values. So there is right upper limb and its SNOMED code. Any kind of date. So now we proceed to the vital parameters. It's not a very good example of components, so I'm going to change it. It is another pre-made component. It isn't very difficult to create. I'm sorry. I'm screwing just a bit. Let's see. So this is SpO2 in percents. It has a little bit of coding it to set the data to the composition. Now I will change the flow rate. Sorry. Here it is. Now I have the proper component, all that data can be set, some data. Now we are going to the respiration part. It has inspired oxygen. As far as I remember from the example, we should set it from one place. So I will delete the slot from both parts and add a new slot where I will set the inspired oxygen section. Now I have it here. It can be changed. It has some validation. It has the rules suggested by the example, which allow us to block the flow rate is when on air is true, or to hide on air choice. Sorry, it can be too big, or it must be only 5 liters. This is a validation from the template. Now I will go to the pulse and heartbeat. We all know that the form isn't only for setting data, but also for data representation. I'll show an example of data representation by adding a chart. This is a chart. It takes data from outer terminology, so it is it can be made also by AQL select. And for example, this is the pulse chart according to the dates. While we are an UI application, our solution is UI. We don't make AQL selects ourselves, but we can take data of any kind from any sources.
Any
openEHR CDR. Yes, any openEHR CDR. So now we proceed to the regularity. Now I will set irregular type to be visible only if irregular is selected. I will go to the hidden property of the component, add regularity value, and add just a little bit of JavaScript coding, which will check if the value of regularity is a key 1028, as far as I remember. So now, if I check irregular, it will appear. Otherwise, it is not seen by the user, so he has no need to select it. You may change the components the way you need. So, for example, there is a better representation of radio button group. Still, we have a lot of dates. We may set, for example, default values will be okay for this. Let it set current date and current time. Next, body size, it's a bit user unfriendly. Let's change it to a drop list so anything can be selected. And we finished this section. We see a validation error here because of lack of data. Now we are on the news UTSP. This is already a finished part of the form, so we may set any kind of data, but we don't have the total score. We need to set it manually. I will change it by adding the last pre-made component in the form. It has the calculation feature, so when you change the value of any field, you will see that total score is changed. Still, you may change the time, select critical risk category, and so on. So here we have finished creating the form and both filling it with most of the data we need. We may now I will show you the JSON. So it is the representation of the composition we have, the one which will be saved. So I can try to save this composition by other testing feature. I guess it's a bit slow at the moment.
Maybe some connectivity.
Yes, I guess connection issues.
Subsidiaries.
But still, the composition is killed. We don't have any validation errors, so it will be saved as it is a timeout error, I suppose. Let me check every field. I guess yes, it's a timeout error. So, but I may show another component maybe, you know, which will help us to show how the form may be saved. I will select navigation, add a slot, and add a good for end user. A component which is useful for end user. This component is widely used in the forums in Moscow. It is a user template component which can help the clinician, for example, to pre-save some data he needs in his work. I may add a new user template, test template, for example. Now, the template is not the composition. It is saved on the backend, and it doesn't go anywhere except our backend. Now, I may clear the whole form, and you may see it's clear. I may select. Yes, I published the form. And open the form in you. That's our demo form. You can see that it is saved. It has some default values in data. I will select test template, and here we go. All the things that a user could enter are saved. So that's as far as you can see the form creation, like building a chair, bought an IKEA, nothing very special. Maybe you may want to see if the multiple blocks could be set to be multiple. I will tune a bit the form. I will set another component. It is a repeater component. Now I need to bind our navigation and repeater. And I will just paste previously created element, and now I may set it in multiple. So I will select another injury, some more info. Now it will be maybe a leg. On some other date, and if we check our JSON, we will see that in the diagnostics there are two different blocks about different traumas, so friction burn and tissue caused by blast. Maybe I'll try to save the company. No, this is something with connection. We may generate Generate data, I guess I'll try. No, it doesn't work.
It doesn't matter much. This is not an evaluation anyway. So.
This is just very good feature for testing the forms and just to load the any composition from your CTR, just to have a look how it looks like at the form. And you can play and test that composition created by the form builder are saved to your CTR. Okay, it's not a problem.
Okay. So that's all for building the form. Let me pass the word to Rostislav, who will explain what was happening.
Sorry.
Okay.
Hi, one more time. Okay, so you. You have seen the form creation based on your requirements, but I guess something was wasn't something may was not very clear. So I will show you how to work with this building tool, and I will show this from scratch. So we have developed a solution for building UI forms, as you have already seen. Here is a list of forms made by several teams. The list of widgets. Widget is a reusable part of the form, so we can create a widget and use it in several forms. And this will speed up form development. And the widgets can be bound to an archetype or a group of archetypes. We also a tool for company for building component libraries. It's not a tool. It's a it's an option for third-party developers to create their own component libraries and to plug.
Excuse us. It sounds like someone else is talking behind you or something.
Yes, there is a fire alarm now.
Fire alarm, okay.
fire alarm.
I guess it's just testing somehow happened.
Okay, we hope.
It's testing, it's not real. Then. Okay.
We hope
I will check if everything is okay, sorry.
Otherwise, we could break and continue if it's a real fire alarm. We don't want to kill you.
Okay.
Can you hear my voice clearly, or this voice from behind?
Yeah, I think it's clear enough. If you're close to the microphone, you will be the loudest.
Okay,
I will hope to. I will try to be louder than this voice from behind, and I hope that there is no fire in our building. Okay. Component, I have talked about component libraries, a very good feature that allows third-party developers to create their own components and to plug in these components to this tool. So we can offer different teams to create their own component, their own visualizations, and their own logic. Okay, now I will start with creating a new form. I will name it demo, and I can select templates. Here we can see that I can select more than one template, and one form can consist of several templates, and as a result, when the user when the end user interacts with this form, several compositions will be saved, each composition for each template. For example, we can select the injury form for entering injuries and for patient information, just for example. But now I will not use this feature, I will continue with creating a form. And okay, here we can see in the center, in the middle of the screen, this is an empty slot where the form is creating and editing. On the left side, here is your template. Here is also a list of components from all component libraries. Different components are represented here. Auto terminologies to use for example, snowman terminologies. And on the right part of the screen, there are different properties for tuning components, form structure, but now the form is empty, and testing tools. And last but not least, in our in the seller, we can see the screen with messages relevant to the form developer. For example, some error messages or warnings. JSON, the resulting composition that will be saved to CDR. Some validation messages and the list of widgets. Okay, there are several different ways how to create a form. The first way is to drag the desired components. I will start with the component vertical stack. It's a system component used for making form layout. They can be vertical and horizontal stacks, and you can make the desired layout. And then I will just drop some checkbox, text fields, maybe date field, and so on, radio group. And our components are loosely coupled to the model. This means that we can make we can bound any property to anything. The most popular way is to bind value. For example, I will bind clinical description value to the text field value. When I make this, I can enter a text here, and it will appear in the JSON in clinical description section of the model. You can see it in the JSON. Another way to create a form, to build a form, is to drag a field from template or an archetype from template. It will be auto-generated. And the most popular way to create a form is, I will just clear everything, is to drag a whole composition as Alexander has made before. And here the form structure is generated, and we can see the stub for a widget. Mm-hmm. As we already said, widgets are reusable parts of the form. A feature that can speed up form development because of reusing. So there are two ways for me. First of all, I can generate a widget from scratch. This will be auto-generated based on a template layout. And the second way, I can choose from existing widgets. For example, I will choose the existing widgets with body image. And as you can see, my form looks like more user-friendly and with the pre-made, pre-tuned components and so on. Next thing to show is dependencies. For example, Alexander told you to how to make the hidden dependency, but the point is that you can add any dependency you want. So there can be hidden dependencies. There can be title property or height property or anything you may wish. Just to demonstrate it, I will bind the label property of this field to the value of the field above. And when I made this, when user enters something in this field, for example, test value, you can see that the title or the label of this configured field also changes. And as you can understand, we can make really flexible forms and dependencies,
multiple dependencies
using this this feature. And if you need some complex dependency, you can use this area to enter any JavaScript code you like. For example, return 123, and the label is now 123. Or you can calculate anything, or you can bind several dependencies, several fields, and make a calculation based on the value of these fields. So you can do anything you like with it. We have different types of components. For example, as Alexander has showed you, we can have chart components, or we can have voice recognition components with the interface for microphone. Using microphone in your in the hints that you have sent to us, you have included the support for including data imported from sensors into forms, for example, pulse oximetry devices. With this voice recognition component, the mechanism is the same. So this is the component which listens to some external device. In our example, this is microphone, and it listens to the microphone or to the voice recognition server via some web sockets. And so we can make, or third-party developers can make any component which any type of component which listens or talks to an external device in the same way. Now I'm going to show you the really fascinating, in my opinion, feature. This is our 3D library. Let us wait while it loads. Takes several seconds to render. Okay, and we can see I think some medical facility for instrumental diagnostics. You can see the 3D models, different rooms different components. And the main concept that these components are built in the same way as 2D components. So this is a component which has its own properties, which can be placed in some place, and which has properties, dependencies, and so on. And the main concept that the visualization can be of any kind, really of any kind. And the mechanism of form building is the same as if this is not an instrumental diagnostic device, but just radio group. Yes, and I would like to show you one more 3D component. I will clear this slot and add, for example, this component. Okay, this is human teeth. And we also can interact with it. We can, for example, drag it and make it. I think someone can have a toothache after this manipulation. But just imagine how can you use it. For example, you can use it for making some notice or some clicking somewhere to set, I don't know, some ache or anything. The main concept, I think I have told you the main concept.
Smart assistant?
Yes, and we also have components like, we call it smart assistant. It's our concept, it's not in production yet. This is a component which helps user to interact with form. It's based on machine learning. It has its own backend with machine learning algorithms. And it shows the user the next field that he is likely
or
to
value,
fill.
Or
it can predict some values. For example, in maybe in future, it will predict the diagnosis based on the information that the system knows about the patient. This kind of component also can be developed and used by used in this solution. Okay, thank you very much. I will pass the word to.
Sorry, we have only one demonstration, one laptop to demonstrate. So let's continue with our presentation. And the next part, we are going to say the words that we usually say at the beginning of the demo. Our company, we are a Solit Clouds company. We are still young for health IT, and we was established in 2014. And our business is software development for healthcare and analytics solution. There are about more than 100 people are working in our company. It's about 60% of the backend and front-end developers. And our biggest project for healthcare is EMEAS. It is a Moscow City Unified Medical Integration and Analytical System. And our experience, we have created a lot of services for city of Moscow. It's some kind of infrastructure services and business services. Infrastructure services, we moved from legacy monolithic system to service-oriented architecture. We have built a master patient index. We have developed resources and scheduled planning system. We have developed appointment system, single access point for all the users, and we have we took part to create the architecture of clinical document storage based on openEHR and so on. And business services. The biggest one is in the user interface for clinician, and that's why our tool helped us to do this work very fast. And another service like instrumental diagnostic system, laboratory diagnostic system, and monitoring center with 3D visualization and so on. It is all about our experience, but today we're not talking about this kind of services. We are talking about, as we understand, you are going to integrate a full scale openEHR solution, and we have integrated almost the same solution for the city of Moscow, but I can say that openEHR solutions that you are looking for are not a silver bullet to make all the healthcare products work, because anyway, openEHR solutions like CDR, our solution EHR forms, so another task planning system, it is just products, and anyway you have to produce a lot of code for UI products and business backend applications products to implement your processes, your healthcare processes, and there is a lot of work, to decrease the costs for the work, we also use different kind of openEHR CDR and such kind of tool, and today we are talking about building a user interface, and to build the user interface for the city of Moscow, we hit several problems. And first of all, developing forms based on openEHR is really time consuming because it big templates, validation rules, composition structure, and tools that there are different kind of tools that allow you just to reflect openEHR template structure to your user interface. It is not a good idea because it is not very useful for the end user, and you have to tune your user interface, your user experience to get the best UI for clinician, to reduce for form filling time and so on. So another problem that we wasn't able to reuse the same UI logic for archetypes or different forms and products, and that's why we have such kind of widgets, components and so on. And we can change forms without releasing new versions of products. Now we can, because we can just change the version of the form and it's already in production. So, and another problem that forms have to be built by front-end developers. Developers need to know openEHR specifications, and developers do a lot of bugs and so on. So to fix all of this project, all of these problems, we decided to implement several features, for today's demo, we want to share insights how solution should be to fix the problems above. And so, first of all, features, it should be fully visible form builder based on openEHR. It means that if you build a form, it should look the same like in end user application and form builder. Application developers shouldn't fix or hack the forms at their site. And next feature, visual elements should be loosely coupled with openEHR model. This allows us to develop visual components and independent. It means that visual components nothing about openEHR composition model, and we're just using binding mechanisms just to make properties work, and we allow users to create widgets for archetypes, not only archetypes, for the structure of archetypes, and reuse them. Reusing them, it means that we implement the search mechanism that allows to find the widget that can be for this archetype, similar archetypes, yes. And we allow different visual component libraries to be developed from with third-party developers. And the last concept that we have every action with the user interface, we record the statistic, we record the log of the end user, and we use it for training machine learning models and to reuse it and to improve the UI logic for the end user interface. And the next that we should talk about, it's top level architecture of our HR form solution. At the screen you can see that your healthcare application produces clinical data as openEHR compositions, and your application includes the openEHR EHR forms rendering library that provides form rendering service, and developers forget about implementing it the forms, they just can implement the process of the application, your clinical process. And another part of HR form solution is HR form builder. It is form building service. It is a tool that that can be used in different ways from with the developer team and or production environment, just to change the forms, and it depends on your requirements. So in our HR forms builder, we have implemented several business functions, and I think that you can also have a look at them, because they are really useful for our tasks. It is a form, one function you have seen, it's form and widget building, and another way, another form and widget management. Also we have a have drafts management service that allow you to play with the form and not to publish it, and not to publish a new version. Also, we can see, we can integrate with openEHR CDRs and also we can upload templates in OPT format to our tool. Also, we have user management. There are different roles like administrator or user, or another feature is component management. And one more feature, it's release management. This feature allows you to create the release, to specify a list of forms and its versions, and after that, publish it to production environment. And another feature is terminology service management. And the result of form building service is a form that is integrated and can be visualized into an end user application. At the screen, you see the HR forms builder architecture. If you are interested, we can talk a lot about this, how it works. You can see also the application structure and deployment schema and deployment artifacts. And you can see that EHR form builder, it means we run it usually on two nodes. It is a node for database, and EHR forms a node that with container orchestration software like Docker Compose or Kubernetes, and we run several Docker containers inside to provide the application. So now our EHR forms backend is connected to openEHR CDR just to tune debug form, and also we can integrate to the form building tool external terminology server, and also we can register component libraries in JavaScript and to our application. So EHR form builder server hardware requirements, it's not we just need two nodes, and one for database, another for server, and here is the hardware requirements. It's not very big. Our solution EHR, I'll say also two words about our solution is can be multi-tenant. It means that you can run different domains or different teams on one instance of the application, or you can deploy multiple applications for different tasks as you want. So the next we're going to talk about EHR form render architecture. EHR forms render, it's just only JavaScript libraries that are integrated to your end user application, and all the communication to save the composition or to feed the render with the data, it is you develop it with your you develop it manually in your application, because when we run the form in production, there are another requirements for security, for communication protocols and communication parts. And our render can use different kind of components, and components are the element that can extend the functionality of the EHR forms. For example, we have different kind of components for voice recognition with its own backend, a smart assistant service with different kind of ML backends. It means that visual components is just it's just a face. It can be 3D if just for visualization or graphics. It can be input fields, or it can be just a face to the external devices or another services that you are running on the backend and so on. And EHR forms, this is a model of the EHR forms. You see that we can include multiple widgets in the form, and every form is built with components, and components are provided by third-party developers as the product library, JavaScript library. Every form is JSON is represented as for JSON file. And I forgot to tell you about releasing. To release the form to production, we have a mechanism that allows us to export forms from one server and to import forms to another server. And you can build the continuous delivery pipeline based on your requirements, just to for to release the form to production. There are a lot of another technical details that we can discuss deeper maybe next time, because I see that we have almost finished, and I think that that's it. That is our result. So thank you.
Thank you very much. So we're getting close to the first part ending and a break. But just to make sure for the recording, so what you are selling is not an openEHR backend system, but a tool to make the front end needed to talk to such a system. Is that correct?
Yes, it is correct. Backend system is the main function is to store data and to provide some kind of search mechanism and so on. But to build the user interface, you need also powerful platform. That's why we.
Yes, I think we understand the difference between front and back end there. And another question before we stop the recording is, what different openEHR backends have you tested this towards? And what are the formats you send things in? I saw it looked like you were using the simplified template format in one place. Can you also send full canonical JSON and XML, for example?
We are using JSON because our openEHR CDR, in production, our openEHR CDR also using JSON format. But we have a converter that allow us to convert our format to canonical openEHR XML format, and as a result, we can communicate with the different openEHR CDRs. But for now, this converter is not running in production. We have developed it, but it is still a thing that needs to be integrated somewhere.
In the templates tab, we can see. We can see the list of templates, and if I press some template, I can, for example, direct examination. We can see the list of forms used in which this template is used.
Ah, wonderful.
And we can go to this form directly. We also see the template structure, and if we press on an archetype, we can see the list of widgets created by this archetype.
Okay, great.
So yes, you can see the list of widgets, the list of forms, and when you press on some forms, I'm sorry, it's Russian for widget names.
We understand the idea, I think, anyway, so that's great.
And you can see the forms in which this widget is used.
Yes,
for
different clinicians, this kind of widget.
Yes, so useful structure, I think. And also, if we press on form, we can see the list of widgets
This is the biggest one.
Yeah, this is the biggest form. We can see the list of widgets.
Some of the widgets are reusable, some are not.
Hmm?
Templates, so,
and list of templates.
Multiple templates.
Yes, multiple templates. It's also interesting feature that allow you to not to be locked in. User interface is not locked in for one template, and you